In this lesson, we will give an introduction to transportation problems, where we'll focus mainly on the basic definitions and we'll look at how the transportation problems are formulated. So what is a transportation problem? Well, a transportation problem is a special type of linear programming problem which also has an objective function which has to be minimized subject to a given set of limitations or constraints. With transportation problems, the main focus is on minimizing the cost of transporting goods, say from some sources to some destination points. So the goods are transported from sources which may be factories to storage centers such as warehouses, or they can be transported directly to the customers. So the overall aim is to minimize the cost of distributing the goods from the supply points to the many destinations. So let's look at an example of a transportation problem. This way you have two supply points, which you can label them as 1 and 2. Then each supply point has a production capacity of S1 for supply point 1 and S2 for supply point 2. Then what is produced at the supply points will be transported to some demand centers, which you can label them as ABC if you have three such demand centers. Then DA denotes the requirement at demand point A, DB the requirement at demand point B, and DC what is required at demand point C. Then in terms of the notation, we will use 1A to denote the cost of shipping one unit from supply point 1 to demand center A. The unit costs of shipping on the other routes are C1B when you're shipping from 1 to B, C1C from 1, so forth. Then the number of units that can be shipped on the route 1 to A is denoted as X1A. Similarly, X1C will represent the number of units that can be shipped on the route 1 to C. X2A is the number of units that can be shipped on the route connecting supply point 2 to supply point A. And X2B from 2 to B, X2C from 2 to C. So this is the notation that will be used in the formulation of the transportation problem. So the transportation problem, there are several ways of representing the transportation problem. One such approach would be to use the network model, where for the example that we've considered, the one with two supply points and demand centers, it takes this structure. Then you use arrows to denote the routes connecting the supply point and the demand center. So for example, on the route connecting 1 and A, X1A denotes the number of units that are shipped route. Then you have C1A denoting the number, sorry, the denoting the cost per unit of shipping, the cost of shipping one unit along this route. Similarly, when you're connecting 1 and p, you have x1p, which is the number of units that are carried on this route, at a cost of c1p per unit. Then you have the connection between 1 and c. Then when you're connecting now from supply center 2 to the demand centers, you have a similar kind of setup. So each arrow shows the route. Then so the total cost now of all, if you suppose that all the routes are being used, so the total cost will be this sum. So where, for example, you have this first product C1A, so if the cost per unit on this route is C1A and X1A units are being shipped, then the cost of using this route, total cost, is C1A times, which is the cost per unit, times the number of units that are shipped. So same for this other route, is this cost per unit times that the number of units. So the total cost then is this sum, which will be our objective function. So to consider the limitations, the capacity, the supply, or the, rather the production capacity of supply center 1 will be x1a, x1b plus x1c, which means that what can be produced plus x1b plus x1c, that is what comes out from supply center 1. Similarly, for supply center 2, you also have the total number of units that can be produced in supply center 2 is equal. Then in terms of the demand, now what goes in, now what goes into A is x1a plus x1b. So what goes in there is what is required, which is dA. Similarly, for demand center B, you have the same structure. What goes in there is x1b plus x2b. Similar for C, you have the same similar equation. So then you want to minimize the total cost subject to this set of constraints. So which means that your transportation problem, when represented as a linear programming problem, now takes this form. You minimize the objective function subject to the given set of constraints. So in the unit on transportation problem, the main focus will be the discussion of algorithms that are used to solve this linear programming problem. Another format for representing the transportation problem is a tabular format, which sort of resembles the tabular form that was used in the simplex method. So in this representation, you put the source centers on the left, then you put the demand centers on the top, on the columns. Then you have the supply capacities on the last column and the demand requirements at the bottom. Then in each cell has a smaller kind of cell where you put the cost per unit. So for example, in this cell, this would be the cost of transporting one unit from 1 to A. Then the number of units that can be shipped on that route is then placed at the bottom there. So this is known as the tabular format of a transportation problem. So you represent the transportation problem in tabular form. It is a convenient representation which is used when you are implementing some of the algorithms for finding the optimal solution. Then finally, we look at the general form. To derive the general form, now you want to generalize the number of supply points and destination points. So if we consider the case where you have m supply points and n destinations, we then use this notation si for the supply capacities for all m supply points. So you have s1, s2 up to sm, denoting the supply capacities. Similarly, we use dj to denote the demand requirements at each demand center. So d1 is what is demanded at demand center 1. Then you have d2, d3 up to dn. Notice that we use I for the supply source and J for the demand destination. So then the cost per unit of shipping one unit from source I to destination J is Cij. Similarly, the number of units that can be shipped on the route from I to J is denoted as Xij. So we have the standard form of the transportation problem, which seeks now to find the minimum cost of transporting Xi units from supply point I to destination J. So that is the question that we want to answer. So then you want to minimize the total cost, which can be represented as this double sum, then subject to the supply constraint and also the demand constraint. Then again, we also have this non-negativity condition, which basically means that the number of units that can be shipped on each route cannot be less than zero. Finally, we consider a special type of transportation problem, which is known as the balanced transportation problem. Now, for a feasible solution to exist, you want to have the total supply being equal to the total demand. So when the total supply is equal to the total demand, which can be represented by this equation, the transportation problem is known as the balanced transportation problem. And when the total supply is not equal to the total demand, then the problem is called an unbalanced transportation problem. So before you solve a transportation problem, you want to make sure that the problem is balanced. So before you attempt to solve, please check if the total supply is equal to the total demand for the given problem.